Very good afternoon to all of you. I'm Vandana from Department of Science and Technology, and I just wanted to tell about Department of Science and Technology. DST is the nodal body in India who formulate policy in related science, who promote science. Today I'll speak about government perspective, Indian government perspective, how to attract young women scientists for this science career. So since morning we are discussing why so few women in science and technology. So the situation is overall, globally is the same, and their social and working environment deeply affect their scientific career. So I'll not go in detail, but overall less than 30% women scientists in India also. And this is also established, if one country has women in a workforce, so its GDP will become high. So these are the different statements of UN. And the graph which we have seen in morning from France, is this, it is typically same in India. In student or graduation level, women, number of women is high, but it is going slow down at professor level. But we go beyond this at leadership role. So there are very few leaders like Dr. Sanghamitra. We have very few women who is leading the institution or universities in India. We can count even on tips. So this becomes the most famous phrase in women in science in India, leaky pipeline. So there are several reasons: break in career due to family responsibilities, and after a break, if they are wanted to come in mainstream, so there are lack of opportunities due to age bar, and system is not allowed because they cross the age. And in India also, in India, there are a number of cities where women education really needs to be promoted. So EGS is because parents do not allow their girls to go send them far away. And critical point is nowadays in India, it's a leadership role. We have a number of women at in leading position at number two, but we have very few leaders at number one position. And limited access, and another thing in science, this we are discussing since morning. There are very few women or girls opting physics, maths, engineering, classical engineering. They are more in life sciences, chemistry. In India, there are a number of women in chemistry also, and information and computer science. So this need to be addressed, and Government of India, particularly Department of Science and Technology, taken some steps to address these challenges. So we are having number of programs which are women specific. So number one is empowering unemployed women scientists. This is the most popular program of Government of India, Women Scientist Scheme. I'll go detail in later on. And one more program is CURIE, that is consolidation of university research for innovation and excellence in women universities. And this program is for infrastructure development and to create research facilities in women only university in India. And the third one is the recent addition. Last year we have started Indo-US fellowship for women in STEM. STEM is science, technology, engineering, mathematics and medicine. And so we have some US visit for 3 to 6 months. Another one is also a very important program, mobility, and that address the relocation issue of women due to marriage or certain other family reasons. So we are giving 5-year project mode platform to continue their research without any break. And we have some capacity building programs, hands-on training, subject-oriented training program, and S&T management training programs. And this sixth last one is S&T for women. This is for grassroots level women. We try to develop their skills so they can earn money, to reduce their drudgery. So Women Scientists Scheme is the most popular program, is a flagship program of DST, and it was started in 2002-03, and the target group is 27 to 15, 7 year of women who are having break in their career. And if they wanted to come in the mainstream after the break, so we provide them fellowship. And they can continue their PhD, they can pursue PhD with this fellowship. And after PhD, if they wanted to come, they can work as a bench level scientist, as we are empowering them as a principal investigator. So in this Women Scientists Scheme, there are three components. If one wanted to do research in basic and applied sciences, there is an option of WSA, Women Scientists Scheme A. And if one wanted to do applied kind of research, which is for the benefit of society, so that one has to choose WSB. And third one is 1 year internship in intellectual property, right? So that they can be self-employed, become a patent agent, and they can also start their own firm. So outcome of this program is around 4,500 women scientists get benefited with this program, and they are contributing with highly impact factor research publications, and about 30% beneficiaries are now in mainstream, and around 15% are continuing with us because they already crossed the age limit for the recruitment. So this is the India map and showing the WSA program. So we covered all the states of India with this program. There is no single state where our women scientists is not there. This kind of, just a photograph to show this kind of research infrastructure we are developing in through Curie program in women only universities. So till now, this program was started in 2009. Till now, we have supported 7 women universities. And except Delhi and Mumbai, other universities are in class B cities and some remote places. So this program is highly impactful to the girls who are living in those particular areas. And so they are get benefited. And we have invested $5.5 million in this program till now. This is the budget allocation of Department of Science and Technology for women-specific programs. We have started in 2003 from 20 million rupees. Now we are at 750 million rupees. So this is the, like, whatever the challenges we were facing in the existing women scientists, but now we are planning. And we wanted to improve in that also. In Women Scientist A, we wanted to start mentor scholar program. So they can be mentored because there are success rate is like 30 to 40% only. So who are the left out, we wanted to come back and we wanted to mentor them. So we are going to start this mentor scholar program. And now this, the new program, this is the big initiative of Department of Science and Technology. This is called as Vigyan Jyoti. And here the objective is to catch them young. And this is the hand-holding program of meritorious girl from the school level till the contractual position. So these are the targets we have set for this program: 50,000 girls at high school or after high school, and 5,000 girls at UG PG level. 1,000 fellowship at research level and 500 contractual position. So this under this program, one thing is also very clear: at UGPG level, preference will be given to the subject areas which are underrepresented. Not in biology. We are not going to give fellowship in biology because already there are more than 50% biologists. So it is in physics, maths, earth sciences, atmospheric sciences, engineering, classical engineering, mechanical, civil, and all that. So Vigyan Jyoti program, like this will start from class 6 to class 8, one component for school level, and we inculcate scientific temperament through fun-filled activities, and this will be the gender neutral because our expert go to the school and they will teach or they tell children and role model or role play and models and all that, they will create excitement for science in these children. And for class 9th, we think math is the mother of all subjects. So we try to focus on maths and all some experimentation kind of thing will be also part, and some other activities must be there. And class 11th, we wanted to them have them subject-oriented program, physics, chemistry, maths, and to prepare them, to mentoring them for the JE examination, various entrance examination, and there will be the role model and interaction with role model, career counseling, parent counseling, and parent counseling will be the part of the all the programs, so that time to time we, whosoever our beneficiary, we give them counseling how to go ahead. And UG PG fellowship, these already the I have already told about it, and we also will include entrepreneurship activities. So this will be the alternate career path for girls. We have conducted one pilot program. So we have conducted at 15 places. So 15 pilot projects, these are completed in this year only. I mean, within 1 or 2 months before. In June, we have actually conducted. This is for class 6 to 8 program conducted at IIT Gandhinagar. So 15 premier organization of India, IITs, ISER, and some universities are part of this pilot project. And these are the models which made by the kids at IIT Gandhinagar. So this is for at Indira Gandhi Delhi Technical University. Project, and the kids made this robots. This is IIT Guwahati program. IIT people provide them a kit and they hands-on experiments they are doing. And this is for class 11 program. This is at IIT Kanpur. Classes plus experimentation, hands-on. You can see the faces of children. They are very happy with this program, and all the mentors are also very happy. Nodal officers, they are happy. So we are planning this mentoring session and all that. So I'm looking forward for exchange program with France in leadership building, like Indo-US, and knowledge sharing for Vigyan Jyoti program also. And knowledge for Vigyan Jyoti program, I really happy that everyone here from India, they wanted to do the same thing. And we are also planning, so we really want your support. All of your supports, because you, most of you are physicists and mathematicians. So really we need help, your help to build this program and make it more successful. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.